Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another worldwide transmission. It is Thursday, the 24th day of May, 2012. We're about to be halfway in to the vaunted 2012. Well, Bilderberg 2012 is going to be big. You've got articles in the Washington Post, multiple articles in Salon, articles in Politico, admitting that, well, these are some people that steer a lot of planetary affairs, but you're still bad if you don't like them. Sure, you conspiracy theorists, that is, people that are informed, were actually right, and that's why you're bad. Well, everybody sees through it. Everybody has enough of a memory to remember the media for decades saying Bilderberg doesn't exist. I remember Rush Limbaugh 20 years ago saying the Council on Foreign Relations did not exist. Now, in the last decade or so, he just says they don't have any power. And this is the type of stuff we deal with. The CFR puts out bi-monthly reports called Foreign Affairs. It's at the bookstore, calling for global government, calling for geoengineering and controlling the weather, calling for restricting free speech, calling for selling the U.S. out to China for globalism. And there's always good reasons, quote, it's always spin, but it's there. And so those of us that actually did the research and knew what we're talking about, we have credibility. And those of you in the dinosaur media are forced to tag along and now go, oh, there is Bilderberg. Yeah, Obama secretly met there 4 years ago. We didn't tell you about that. But now we are. Look, they just went to the main page of the Council on Foreign Relations and what's on it today. The guys just went there. What is it? CFR.org? I forget their exact URL. What's the exact URL? They're looking that up? Yeah, that's right. CFR.org. That's right. CFR.org. Oh, look on the front page. Global governance. Click on that. Big, giant. I mean, there's no global government. But the first thing they have in giant black letters is global governance. And I've had these people on, like the head of the Kissinger Group, Rothkopf, because he thought I was Alex S. Jones. I can't tell you how many times we've gotten big fish on the show because they think I'm Alex S. Jones, who does a radio commentary or did in the past for NPR and, you know, New York Times guy. And he gets on, he goes, oh, you're that Alex Jones. And then I got on with Rothkopf during the break, and he knew who I was. And he goes, okay, well, I'll just finish the interview. But I called him back later to get him on. His secretary said, no, not after last time. But he goes, well, we don't want global government. We want global governance. Of course, governance means government. And they play these mind games with the public. So doesn't exist, though. You go to their website today, and it says global governance. Unelected mega bankers who are totally ruthless running our lives. Speaking of running our lives, the system is, again, through government contracts, taxing us. Private corporations are destroying us. They've taken over the government, whether it's big pharma and big agra like Monsanto, or whether it's the big defense contractors who get a lot of their parts made in China now. Boeing's moved to China. General Motors moving to China. Everything moving there. And China coming in and buying the biggest theater chain, buying huge controlling positions in the big Hollywood production companies. A year and a half ago, they had to stop the release of the Red Dawn movie and go back and reshoot it so that it's North Koreans invading. Oh, that's real believable. They can't even get their cars to start because they're under such communism. But the communist Chinese, they said, we don't want that movie to come out. And so Hollywood said, okay, we'll redo the movie. And now it's in limbo. Like, I've got to look at the update on that and find out what the latest is. I know Watson did a story on it a few days ago, but this is the type of stuff that we're dealing with here, and we're going to be breaking it down. So they have announced weaponized drones. I mean, I told you. Oh, we'll never have drones over here. Yeah, we'll have 30,000. Yeah, they're going to have hand grenades and shotguns. Again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank all of you. across the planet, listening on XM channel 166, over 100 AM and FM transmitters here in the United States, WWCR 100,000 watt global world service shortwave, and of course, those of you listening to the free podcast later, those listening to the live streams, I want to welcome everyone listening to this transmission and people watching on prisonplanet.tv. Dr. Corsi was already on with us with an update. He was actually in Hawaii investigating. He didn't want us to say that at the time. Now we can. He's there with the cold case posse sent by Sheriff Joe Arpaio. And he's got some new breaking news here for us. He'll be on with us for about 30 minutes at the start of the next hour. And the rest of the broadcast will be open phones and news. Obviously, CBS News is reporting that the new arms race worldwide is governments arming against their populations. Drones with hand grenade launchers, gas launchers, 12-gauge shotguns, 30,000 of them to be deployed against the American people, Brigade Homeland, combat troops on the streets, TSA as the first contact group that will then tell you you're detained and have an army truck pull up and get you. Re-education camps are built. Army admits those documents are authentic. We have a complete criminal group in control. And if the police and military and public follow the narrative that's going to be rolled out, we're going to go into deepest tyranny, controlled, designed implosion and depression with the criminals that engineered it posing as saviors. Now, this was actually reported on back in April, but it got a lot of the news yesterday when Drudge linked to CBS groups concerned over arming of domestic drones. That headline actually got changed overnight. The link did. It was police move to arm drones. And the very companies that they report on here are the ones that already have combat drones, small ones, with 12-gauge shotguns. You can buy these just as a citizen. 12-gauge shotguns on them, I know, because we're doing a report on drones and we're looking at drones, and we don't have the budget to buy a $2,000 drone that has a mount for a 22 or 12-gauge. But the police departments already have these. And we're talking about a couple $1,000s for one of these bad boys. $5,000 for a 1/5 scale helicopter you can put rocket launchers on. You can put the rocket launchers on it, you just can't put the warheads on it unless you're a police agency. So the arms race is on. And I remember all these years ago, I warned you from MIT documents that were public, Pentagon, DARPA documents that were public, that they said by 2012 they wanted half the Air Force to be drone. It's 2012. More than half the Air Force is now drone. Last time I checked, the Air Force has something like 10,000 Predators, another 8,000 ordered. The Army has thousands of them. The Marines have thousands of them. Thousands. Thousands. I think what the Army has a couple thousand, the Marines have a couple thousand. You think the Army would have more than the Marines. The Marines have got a bunch of these little helicopters that they call Scout, gray helicopters with missile launchers on them, and it's on. And I did some searching last night. I mean, I'd already seen these articles over the last year, but I did some searching and pulled these articles back up. Police departments all over the country have bought combat drones. I remember talking to a Marine Corps captain source who told me about the combat robots they had in 99. Then I went to an urban warfare drill and was talking to some of the officers, a colonel and others. And when I brought up combat drones that were actually four-legged and things, they got very upset and said, you need to get out of here. They were acting real friendly until I brought that up. But the minute you bring up something classified like that, because they know their whole career is over, if they even act like they're talking to you, they freak out. Hey, a secret armies of robots against the American people is not kosher, okay? And it's not going to fly, pun intended. I noticed in a video I shot last night and uploaded about 10, dealing with the drones, that's at Infowars.com, drones to attack the American people, armed drones to attack the American people is the headline, linking to the other articles in a boil down that Paul Watson did yesterday, with links to the different stories. I noticed people saying, oh, get the tinfoil hats out, everybody. This is Salon, drones for urban warfare. Manufacturers are targeting U.S. police forces for sales as drones move from the Middle East to the Main Street. Okay? Here's CBS last night. Groups concerned over arming of domestic drones. I mean, right here in Texas, they've got combat drones. Combat drones with shotguns and grenade launchers. And they go on to say they want them for crowd control with speakers and rubber bullets. They always phase it in with a less lethal. They call them non-lethal on the news, but they're really called less lethal inside the industry to get you used to the image of drones firing on people. And then next, it's real weapons. Or the taser only kills you, you know, one out of 30 or 40 people. So they up the power 30% or more. Now it kills even more people. This is what's going on. This is the real world. And just saying tinfoil hat isn't going to protect you. Oh, we said they'd have a global government run by six megabanks. Those exact six megabanks that I told you about over a decade ago are announcing global government as the solution to the derivatives crisis they created. The re-education camps are admitted. Everything is coming out in the open. But so many of the population are preconditioned that they can't resist it via Stockholm syndrome, mass collective Stockholm syndrome, mass denial, cognitive dissonance, learned helplessness, and the normalcy bias. And this is why the Germans did what they did. They were much more hardworking and moral and upright than I've looked at the sociology, the history, the anthropology. The Germans of the 30s were so much more moral than Americans are today, it'd make your head spin. Just like Americans of the 30s were much more moral. America is going to go so much worse than Nazi Germany or Soviet Russia if these globalists have their way. I mean, how many clips do I have to give you? You heard Lord Monckton here yesterday sourcing mainstream news saying, arrest and kill those of us that don't believe in man-made global warming and don't want to pay Al Gore and Barack Obama money to their climate exchange. They say, kill us. Kill us. I can play you the informant who was at the highest levels of the weatherman. This later came out in court and Ayers had to admit it, where they planned to put 50 plus million in camps and kill half of us, 25 mil. And again, your normalcy bias won't let you deal with that. We have sickening scum who don't care about having a happy, safe, good country. They want power. They want to dominate. It's a will to power. And if we don't get really aggressive with these globalists, they're going to stage terror attacks, and they're going to shut down the internet as we know it, and they're going to come and arrest Alex Jones. And they're going to come, and they're going to arrest even people who think they can work with a system like Glenn Beck and Rupert Murdoch. You're all going to jail, and they're getting that ready. I told you that was coming years ago. When they start going after News Corp, you know they're going after everybody else, because it's seen in the power structure as an enemy. Not that it isn't even part of the power structure, but the power structure will start eating its own. And when you see the globalists eating their own and power struggles at the very top, that means they're going into the hot phase. And it's going to result in civil war in this country. It's going to result in dead cops piled up to the sky and dead citizens. And I'm telling you, you better get over your normalcy bias and your learned helplessness and your mass Stockholm syndrome right now. The system wants to give everybody these toys as a psychological warfare device to scare everyone and to have forward observers, armed drones, so that people feel like resistance is futile. Well, everybody has shown in psychology aerial bombardment actually unifies populations. But this is a tinker toy, so the police can go under federal control. They have to do that to have these drones. And feel like, you know, they're playing a video game when they're killing citizens. It's to remove the humanity from it. And here's the rest of the story. By 2020, they intend to have the entire combat force of ground troops and forces in the air, the entire force will be robots. They intend to have the entire force. That's why they're getting ready to put women in frontline combat and have all this, because that's all gone. There's not going to be humans going to space. There's not going to be humans.